Hello everyone, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. In this tutorial, we're going to look at how to find the square root of a complex number. So just before we go to finding square roots, let's see if you guys remember how to find something squared. So if I give you z equals, let's say 2 plus 3i, you should be able to tell me what z squared is. Okay, so have a go at that, come back when you're done. Okay, so the answer is negative 5 plus 12i. So I want you guys to test it out in GeoGebra, just see if it's the same. So if I do 2 plus 3i in GeoGebra and I square it, I get negative 5 plus 12i, which is what I have. So it's correct. Okay, now what is the square root mean? Well, the square root just means the opposite of squaring it. So if I square root negative 5 plus 12i, I should get 2 plus 3i. The question is, how would you find that? How would you know that is 2 plus 3i if we had no idea what it was? How would we find it? Okay, so that's what this tutorial is about, finding the square root of a complex number. So we know that the answer is going to be in the form a plus bi, right? Because if you square root a complex number, you should get a complex number as well, right? So we just need to find what a is and what b is. So how do we do that? Well, from this equation, let's now square both sides. So if I square both sides, then that means I have negative 5 plus 12i on the left, since the squared sign cancels out with the square root. And on the right hand side, I have a plus bi squared, which is a plus bi bracket a plus bi. So if I simplify the right hand side, if I expand it out, using binomial expansion, then I will get a squared plus 2abi minus b squared. Okay, so now what happens is, because we have two complex numbers that are equal, that means the real part of each complex number should be equal, and the imaginary part of each complex number should be equal. So let's make the real part equal to each other first. Right, now what is the real part of the left hand side? The real part of the left hand side is negative 5, right? Because the real part doesn't involve the imaginary number, so it's just negative 5. What is the real part of the right hand side? Well, the middle term here has an imaginary number after it, so a squared minus b squared is the real part of the complex number on the right hand side. Okay, now let's make the imaginary part equal to each other. So imaginary part of negative 5 plus 12i is equal to the imaginary part of a squared plus 2abi minus b squared. So 12, which is the imaginary part of the left hand side because it's the coefficient of I, is equal to, the coefficient of I here is 2ab. Okay, now we're going to rearrange it to make a the subject on this second equation. So a is equal to 12 over 2b. So I simply move the 2 and the b to the left hand side. And now I can substitute this expression for a into where a is in that other equation. Okay, so then I will get negative 5 equals 12 over 2b squared minus b squared. And you can see we're very close to finding b. Okay, we know the answer to b is, we know the answer to b already. B is going to be 3, right? But let's just see if we can find it. So now I'm going to get rid of this squared sign. So negative 5 equals 144 over 4b squared minus b squared. Let's multiply the whole equation by 4b squared just so I can get rid of this fraction. So this whole side by 4b squared and this whole side by 4b squared. So then I will get negative 20b squared equals 144 minus 4b to the power of 4. Okay, because 144 times 4b squared divided by 4b squared just gives you 144. And 4b squared times b squared is 4b to the power of 4. Let's move everything to the left-hand side. So I have 4b to the power of 4 minus 20b to the power of 2 minus 144 is equal to 0. Now, you must be asking, how do we solve this equation, right? Because it has b to the power of 4. That's a whatever you call it after a cubic, right? So it's very hard to solve. So what we want to do is try to make up another variable. I'm just going to make up another variable called x. And x is equal to b squared. Why do we do that? Because if I make up this variable, then what happens is I can replace b squared with x in the equation above it. So then I can simply do 4x squared minus 20x minus 144 is equal to 0, right? Basically, I replace b squared with x. B to the power of 4 is b squared to the power of 2, so that's x to the power of 2. So then I can simply solve this using the quadratic formula. Now, just want to remind you guys that on my website there's a quadratic equation solver as well, if you don't want to use the quadratic formula, because the quadratic formula is pretty long. So unless you enjoy substituting numbers into the formula. So just show you guys how to sub it in. So it's positive 20. All right, actually I'll just show you. This is B, this is A, and this is C. Okay, don't forget the sign is included in the term. So instead of substituting all that in, I'm just going to show you guys how to find the quadratic equation solver on my website. So if you go to my website, magicmonktutorials.com, you can just scroll down to where it says Math Programs Quadratic Equation Solver. And then you can simply enter 4, negative 20, and negative 144 into A, B, and C and click Solve. And you can see here that there are two answers for x. X can either be 9 or negative 4. So you can say x is 9 or negative 4. Okay, so we found what x is, but our goal is to find out what b is. Right, because if we find out what b is, we pretty much found our answer, okay? Because basically in our original equation, b is 3. So how do we find out what b is? Well, x is equal to b squared, so either 9 is equal to b squared. Actually, I'm just going to write b squared equals 9 a bit easier. Or b squared equals negative 4. if b squared is equal to 9, then b is equal to plus or minus 3. If b squared is equal to negative 4, then b is equal to square root of negative 4. And since b is a real number, ignore b is square root of negative 4. Right, because we don't want a complex number. We don't want a complex number for b. Right, because if you remember our original equation, just gonna write it here again. Square root of negative 5 plus 12i equals a plus bi. B is a real number, even though it's the coefficient of an imaginary number. B is a real number itself. Okay, so we want to find what b is, so therefore, let's go back to this equation. Ignore b equals square root of negative 4. So b is either 3 or negative 3. So let's keep that in mind, okay? We haven't found it yet. We haven't made sure which one it is yet. But what we're going to do is substitute this b number back into what equation the equation that we found earlier, where negative 5 equals a squared minus b squared. So let's put that in. Negative 5, or you can just do 12 equals 2ab, doesn't matter. So let's put that in. 12 equals 2ab. Okay, so if 12 is equal to 2ab, then a is equal to 12 over 2b. So that's 12 over 2 times 3, which is 12 over 6, which is 2. That's the first possibility. So if b is equal to 3, a is equal to 2. If b is equal to negative 3, then a is equal to 12 over 2 times negative 3, which is 12 over negative 6, which is negative 2. So let's go back to our answer. And what we had was square root of negative 5 plus 12i is a plus bi. So it is equal to either 2 plus 3i or negative 2 minus 3i. Okay, so there are two possible answers. Now let's just check that in GeoGebra. Okay, so we have 2 plus 3i squared, and we already know the answer is negative 5 plus 12i. Now let's try the other one, negative 2 minus 3i squared. So let's delete all this and let's do negative 2 minus 3i squared. And the answer is also negative 5 plus 12i. So there are two answers. Okay, now let's talk about why that is. So the first equation that we had was 2 plus 3i. So we got 2 plus 3i, which is z1. And let's do negative 2 minus 3i. Wait, let's do 2 plus 3i squared. So 2 plus 3i squared, that gave us negative 5 plus 12i. Now let's have a look at the magnitude of both of these complex numbers. So starting from 0, if we look at the line that goes to z1, which is 2 plus 3i, the magnitude is 3.61. Remember, when we multiply complex numbers together, we multiply their magnitudes. So z1 times z1, the magnitude is 3.61. So 3.61 times 3.61 is 13. Okay, now let's look at the angle, the argument. So the argument of this complex number z1, I'm only creating the point B so I can find out the angle of z1. The angle is 56.31. Now, if I square it, I add together the angles. Okay, so z1 times z1, so I add the angles 56.31 plus 56.31, then what do I get? I get I get 112.62. So 56.31 plus 56.31 is 112. Okay, let's look at our other option. Our other option was negative 2 minus 3i. So let's draw that. Negative 2 minus 3i, which is complex number z3, it also has a magnitude of 3.61. So z3 times z3 will give you a magnitude of 13 as well. Now let's look at the angle of z3. Z3 has an angle of, let's draw it the other way. So z3 has an angle of 123.65. Let me just confirm that. Angle z3, 0, b. So z3 has an angle of 123.69. Let me just use another color for this angle. Now, if I square z3, what happens is I will also add together the angles. Now, 123.69 plus 123.69. Remember how, because we're going clockwise from the horizontal, this angle is actually negative. So negative 123.69 plus negative 123.69 will give you, from B to Z2, oops, let's do it this way, will give you 247.38 negative. So we're going counterclockwise from the positive x-axis all the way to Z2. Let me get a different color for you. Counterclockwise from the positive x-axis all the way to Z2 is negative 247.38 degrees. Okay, so that is the reasoning behind why, when you square root a complex number, there are two answers. Okay, thanks for watching, guys.